वेलकम स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी न्यूमेरिकल ऑन वेपर कंप्रेशन साइकिल साइकिल पार्ट थर्ड। नाउ लुक इन द फर्स्ट न्यूमेरिकल प्रॉब्लम। ए वी सी रेफ्रिजरेशन सिस्टम यूजिंग R12 प्रोड्यूसिंग 8640 kg ऑफ आइस पर डे एंड द कंडेंसिंग एंड द ऑपरेटिंग टेम्परेचर आर 48 डिग्री सेल्सियस एंड -20 degrees Celsius respectively. The cycle is a simple VC cycle, means that the saturated vapor enter into the compressor. The water at temperature 35 degrees Celsius is used to form ice, and the temperature of ice should be -8 degrees Celsius. So the water at 35 degrees should be converted into the ice. The freezing point of the water is -8 degrees Celsius, and heat flow to the brine trying from the surrounding may be taken as 10% of the total heat removed from the water to form the ice at -8 degrees Celsius. So the total amount of heat extracted from the water at a temperature of 35 degrees Celsius to convert into ice at -8 degrees Celsius, the 10% of total amount should be heat entered into the brine tank from the surrounding. In this problem, we have to calculate the power required to drive the plant. This is some value. Take a specific heat of the ice is 2.26 kilojoule per kg Kelvin, and the latent heat of the ice is given 334.72 kilojoule per kg, and the specific heat of water is given 4.8 kilojoule per kg Kelvin, and the specific heat of the vapor refrigerant is 0.82 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. And this following data of the R12 is given, that according to the temperature and the pressure. Then look how to solve this problem. This is a very important problem, which is asking the AS problem. In this problem, you have to find the power input. First, you write the formula of the power input. Power input is equal to mass flow rate S2 minus H1. You don't know about the mass flow rate and the H2 value. So first you have to find the H2 value and the mass flow rate. This is a TS diagram of simple VC cycle of the brine tank. You can see that this is the brine tank, and here is the ice of, and here the brine solution should be there, and the heat from the surrounding should be entered into the brine tank also. We have to also consider that heat input to the brine tank, and this 10% of heat of total heat extracted should be extracted by the refrigerant. So we have to calculate the total amount and add the 10% of amount. Then this total amount is a refrigerant effect and the RC value. So in the formula, you can see that power input is equal to mass flow rate S2 minus H1. H1 is given from the table. You can see that from the table, H1 is equal to Hg at temperature of -20 degrees Celsius. So you have to find first S2. So then we have to write the formula of S2 value in the superheated region, which is equal to S2 dash plus a specific heat of vapor, which is given 0.82, and temperature T2 minus T2 dash. This is enthalpy at here at that point, and the enthalpy from 2 dash to 2 is written as a specific heat multiplied by the temperature difference of superheated region. So you can write the S2 dash value from the table, which is saturated vapor at temperature of 48 degrees Celsius. In the table, on the table you can go, you can find the value of S2 dash. Cp of vapor is given, T2 dash also given, which is 48 degrees Celsius, which is converted into the Kelvin first. Then from here you have to find T2, but you didn't know the value of S2 value. So first you find S1. Write the formula of S1 is equal to S2, because entropy in the compressor should be isentropic. So S1 is equal to S2, because isentropic compression should be there in the compressor. And S1 you can write the S1 is value is Sg value at temperature of minus 20 degrees Celsius. So S1 is equal to 0.70877 equal to S2. S2 formula in superheated region, the entropy formula in superheated region. You can write here the S2 dash you can find from that table at temperature of 48 degrees Celsius and plus write the formula of superheated entropy change in the superheated region, which is equal to Sp Cp specific heat of the vapor into latent heat into ln T2 by T2 dash. This is come from here. The change in the entropy in this in any system, which is Cp ln T2 by T1 minus R ln P2 by P1. But this line should be the constant pressure line. So the this pressure is constant and this unit should be constant. So entropy change from 2 dash to 2 is equal to Cp ln T2 by T1, just like that. So put the value of S2 dash T2 dash, then you from this formula you find the T2. You got the T2 value 331.6 kilo Kelvin. And this T2 value, you put the T2 value in S2 formula. From S2, you find the value of S2. S2 is equal to 214.5522 kilojoule per kg. Then you have to find the total heat removed from the water at the water at temperature of 35 degrees Celsius. It should be converted into ice at minus 8 degrees Celsius. So write the first you write the formula of heat removed from the water. This is S2 at 35 degrees Celsius will be converted into ice at minus 8 degrees Celsius. So the S2 is 35 degrees Celsius is converted into at 0 degrees Celsius, which is given written as mass flow rate into a specific heat of water and the temperature difference from 35 to 0. Then this S2 at 0 degrees Celsius converted into ice at 0 degrees Celsius, which is mass flow rate and the latent heat of the ice. Then next phase is the ice at 0 degrees Celsius converted into ice at minus 8 degrees Celsius, which is written as mass flow rate and the specific heat of the ice and the temperature difference from 0 to minus 8 degrees Celsius. So the total heat, the heat removed is equal to this. From here you can take the common mass flow rate m value. Then the mass flow rate is equal to the 8640 kg divided by 24 hour into 3600, which is converted to the second. Now this is the mass flow rate, and the put the value of Cp and temperature of different phases. Then you find the value of heat, total heat removed from the water. But you can, in the problem is given that the 10% of total heat, this total heat is leak into the tank. So first you convert the total heat removed from the tank is 49.9. This is heat removed from the water, and this is 10% of heat is enter into the brine tank, which is extracted by the refrigerant also, and this should be added in the total heat removed, and this total heat removed is equal to the refrigerant effect of the system. So from here you can find the mass flow rate of the refrigerant. This is mass flow rate of the mass flow rate of waters, and this is mass flow rate of the refrigerant. So you can find the mass flow rate then they put the value of mass flow rate and achieve value in the power input. You can find the power input, which is equal to the 20.4 kilowatts. Now move to second very important question, which is based on the cascade system. A cascade refrigeration system of 100 TR capacity uses ammonia and CO2. So there are two system using, which is one using the ammonia and the other system using CO2, and total capacity is 100 TR. The refrigerating and condensing temperature of CO2 are given. Temperature given minus 40 degrees Celsius and 5 degrees Celsius respectively. The evaporating temperature of NH3 is minus 7 degrees Celsius. The power is supplied to the NH3 is corresponding to 96.5 kilowatts. So the power input should be given for the NH3 value, NH3 refrigerant system. So the CO2 cycle and the NH3 cycle are assumed to be simple Vc cycle. So the both cycles should be working on the simple Vc cycle. Calculate the mass flow rate of CO2 and overall scope of the refrigeration system. Use the following table for the property of CO2. This table is given for the CO2 value, CO2 refrigerant only. And put and use the value of Cp of vapor is equal to 0.85 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. So in this question, there are two refrigerant systems should be there. One is one system using the ammonia and the other using the CO2. In the ammonia system, the power input should be given. You have to find the mass flow rate of CO2 and the overall power of the system, overall scope of the system. First, you draw the TR diagram of cascade system. This is NH3 refrigerant system, and this is a CO2 refrigerant system. And here, this CO2 refrigerant system extracts the heat from the storage stage, and this is refrigerant effect. You can say the refrigerant capacity, which is extracted by the CO2 refrigerant system. Then, in the question, total refrigerant system should be given is 100 TR, and 1 TR is equal to 3.5 kilowatts. So then RC is equal to 350 kilowatts. Then RC refrigerant capacity is equal to the mass flow rate of CO2, because we have to find the power input of CO2, because the power input of NH3 is already given in the question. So you write the formula of the power input, refrigerant capacity of CO2. Then you have to find the first mass flow rate of CO2. Here H1 and H3 is given. Here H1 and H3 is given in the table. You can find the table. H1, which is saturated vapor at temperature minus 40 degrees Celsius, and this is saturated liquid at temperature of minus 5 degrees Celsius. So from the table, you find the value of H1 and H3, then put the value of H1 and H3 in the refrigerant capacity formula. Find the mass flow rate of CO2, which is equal to 1.5 kilo kg per second. Then find the scope of overall system. The refrigerant capacity of the whole system should be given, which is 100 TR, which is equal to 350 kilowatts. So RC is given, but you have to find the power input, because power input should be addition of the power input of CO2 and the power input of NH3. So you have to power input of NH3 should be given in the question, but you have to find the power input of the CO2 refrigerant system. So then we write the power input formula of CO2 system. The power input is equal to mass flow rate of CO2 is equal to H2 minus H1, which is H2 minus H1. H1 is given, which is saturated vapor at temperature of minus 40 degrees Celsius, which is you can find from the table. And mass flow rate of CO2 we already find here. Entropy at superheated region. So the entropy of superheated region S2 is equal to S2 dash plus Cp ln T2 by T1. and this S2 is equal to S1 because the in the compressor isentropic process should be there. So S1 is equal to Sg at temperature of minus 40 degrees Celsius. So you can put the value of S2 is equal to S1. Then from this formula you have to find the T2 value. Then write the formula of enthalpy at superheated region, which is equal to S2 is equal to S2 dash plus Cp of vapor and temperature difference of superheated region T2 minus T2 dash. So put the value of T2 and S2 dash from the table, which is equal to 5 vapor at a temperature of 5 degrees Celsius. So from here you find the value of S2, which is equal to 720.5 kilojoule per kg. Then the power input of CO2 is equal to mass flow rate of CO2 and S2 minus H1. Put the value of S2 minus H1 and mass flow rate, you find the value of power input of CO2, which is equal to 106.3 kilowatts. Then find the COP of overall system, which is RC of, which is given 100 TR divided by the power input of CO2 plus power input of NH3. The power input of NH3 is already given in the question, and the power of CO2 you already find here. So put the value of RC and the power input of CO2 and NH3, and you can find the value of COP of whole system is equal to 1.72. Thank you. This is all for today's lecture.